One quick addition to that last lab before we move on to the router election. One thing you should do after you've got your virtual router up and running and everything looks good on your multi-layer switches is to go to one of your hosts and make sure they can ping that new virtual router. So I just went out to host 3, which was already in VLAN 100, and pinged 172.16.23.12 from there. No problem at all, and the pings came right back. So let's talk about this election for a few minutes, and then we're going to jump in the lab really quick and look at changing the results of this election. The priority, that HSRP priority, it's the first value considered in the election. Now, the priority is 100 by default. We saw that on both routers. And just a quick reminder of where to find that. Of course, you know it's in show standby. Everything's in show standby. But your local router is going to be right down here, your priority. Priority 100. Notice it says default 100. I think that word in front of the number there in the paren is going to change. So we want to watch that. But there's the priority. So everything looks fine there, except should there be a tie? Well, there always will be a tie if we leave the routers at their defaults. Theory holds that the router with the highest IP address wins the election. Now, Multilayer Switch 2 won the election in our first lab and had the highest IP address on the SVI. So the theory holds true, and that could be any interface. But the problem there is that doesn't always work, and I'm speaking real world here. Always, always, always verify your active router. I know I say to verify everything, but you really want to verify this because I've seen routers with lower IP addresses win that election and the priorities are the same and everything else is the same. So you just want to verify that. For your exam, you know, we're going to hold the theory that the highest IP address wins the election. So let's go ahead and make multilayer switch 1 the active router because we know in the real world, it's just like our root switch elections. We don't always want to leave that up to the MAC address. So maybe I've got one particular workhorse switch here and another one that's not so much. You know, so I want to make the first switch the multi-layer switch. So let's just go into inner VLAN 100, interface VLAN 100, standby 5, and we just use the priority option. And your priority is 0 through 255. So I'm going to go double or nothing here and double the default priority. And to get a console message, but it's just the old configured from console by console message. We're pretty used to seeing that one. We don't see anything about a state change, though. And this is good and bad on MLS-1. The good part of it is that the priority change did take effect. There it is. Priority 200, configure 200. Whenever we see configured, we know that somebody hard-coded that particular priority. The bad news is that there wasn't a state change. We could see here, first off, state is standby. So router 1, multilayer switch 1, didn't take over as the active. And the last state change was 9.5 minutes ago. So, you know, not so much here. What happened? Well, the deal is with HSRP that either, in this case, multilayer switch 2 has to disappear for 1 to take over in its absence. We don't really want to do that. We don't want to reload the switch. What we'll do much more commonly is use the preemption option. Okay, preemption is disabled by default in HSRP. And here's the preempt option. Overthrow lower priority active router. Sounds kind of violent. You know, I don't overthrow. That's pretty violent. But that's the only option. That's the one we're going to use. When you enable preemption, then a router can take over as the active if it has a higher priority than the current active. Because right now, switch 1 has a priority of 200. Switch 2's got a priority of 100, but it's keeping its role as the active. Let's see what happens when we enable preemption. And you just put preempt, and that's it. And in a very short period of time, and I'll move this over so you can see it. I know that timestamp is long. The state change, HSRP 5 state change, VLAN 100 group 5 state standby to active. So it sounds like it did exactly what we wanted it to do. And it did, because now this is the active router. This is the active router, 2 state changes. It just changed 17 seconds ago. All the IP address and hello time and all that stuff stays the same. But preemption is enabled. Active router is local. And here's the standby router 23.2 with a priority of 100. Remember, the priority it mentions here is the priority of the local router. So it did exactly what we wanted it to do, but that's the key. It's not enough just to go in there after the election and raise the priority of the switch you want to be the active router. That's not enough. You've either got to reload the active router, which we generally don't want to do, or just enable preemption. There is one option here, too. I'm going to show you this. There are some options there for preempt. Because those of you who've seen, and you might still see an iOS version where this happens, you used to be able to set preempt at the end of the priority command. And I don't think you can do that anymore, period, but you might bump into an older iOS that does let you do that. I do want to show you these options, though. You can delay the preemption. So if you want to say, okay, I want to wait 10 seconds before preempting, or I want to delay it until after a reload, then you can do that. You might run into specialized situations where you want to do that. The sync option, do not concern yourself with that right now. But let's look at minimum. And it's just the number of seconds for minimum delay. So, you know, again, you might run into some specialized situations out there in real world networking, but generally for lab work, it's good. They're good options to know, please don't get me wrong. But generally, when I preempt, I want to go ahead and just do it right then and there. That's really it. So that is it for this particular lab. We are going to head to the next video now. We're going to talk about those state changes. We've seen a couple of those in action. We've seen active, standby, certainly. We've seen active and standby in all of our labs. But I want you to know about the stages that lead up to those, and we'll talk about that on the very next video.